All the 12th students, 12th biology students, please be ready. I am going to start the chapter 2, biology in class 12th. Please be seated. Ready? Come and join. Myself, Jalaja Sajeev, PGT Bio, KV BSF Camp, Chavla, in front of screen. Welcome you one and all for the second part, Class 12th Biology Chapter 2, that is Sexual Reproduction in Flowering Plants. So the previous knowledge before going to this aspect, that is the typical structure of a flower, the structure of a typical flower, its different parts and their function. You know the carpel, that is the mega sporophyll, and the different parts of a carpel. You know what is carpel? It is the unit of gynecium or pistil. And yesterday we have learned about the different parts of carpel also. What are the different parts of a carpel? Yes, come forward. Stigma, style, and ovary. Good. So the gist of the content that we are going to cover today in this session is the structure of a ovule, what are the different types of ovule, megasporogenesis, development of megasporophyte, structure of a mature embryo sac, pollination and different types of pollination, and the different characters of the flowers that shows different types of pollination. Now the instructional objective of this particular content area, that is enable you people to understand and analyze, identify and explain, describe, illustrate, distinguish, or even develop skill in drawing different aspects, different diagrams that are included in this topic. So after learning all these content areas, our outcome, learning outcome will be, you will be able to analyze the different type of ovules present in a plant, and you can identify the different types of ovules present in different plants. You can illustrate, describe, or depict the diagrams of megasporogenesis, development of a megasporophyte. You can explain the structure of a mature embryo sac. And you can identify the different types of flowers based on the characters that is meant for different types of pollination. So all these aspects that you can gain after going through these different content areas. So the first aspect here is ovule. You know, ovule is known as megasporangium. So what is megasporophyll? Carpel. Carpel is known as megasporophyll. And in that carpel, the basal swollen part, that is ovary. Ovary contains the ovules. And a single ovule is known as megasporangium. Now, from where it originates? It originates as a mass of tissue, as a mass of meristematic tissue, that is primordium in the placenta. And an ovule, a typical ovule, it possesses a stalk. And that stalk of the ovule is known as funicle. You can see the funicle, and it is attached with the placenta. Funicle that is attached with the placenta. Then what is a hilum? That means the point at which the funicle is attached with the ovule. Funicle, the stalk of the ovule, is attached with the body of the ovule at a particular point, and that point of attachment, that is known as hilum. Now, what is the tissue that is seen inside the ovule? So, inside an ovule, there present a homogeneous tissue. All the cells are of same type, and it is made up of parenchyma cells. And those cells that forms the homogeneous tissue, the diploid tissue, which is seen inside the ovule, that is known as nucellus. So, what is the ploidy of a nucellus? One more question for your exam. It is diploid. Another question, name the homogeneous tissue that is seen inside the ovule and give its ploidy or chromosome number. So, your answer is nucellus and its chromosome number, that is diploid. Now, this homogeneous tissue, it is well protected with the help of protective layers, coverings. And those protective coverings, that is known as integument. There are two coverings, two integuments, outer integument and inner integument. Then these integuments, they are not entirely covering the ovule. It produces a small opening at one end of the ovule, and that is known as micropyle. At one end of the ovule, these integuments that produces a small opening, and that opening is known as micropyle. Here you can see the diagram also. All these aspects are clear here. Once again, you can see here the funiculus is single. Funiculus, singular form, and funicle, plural. So, funiculus or funicle, it is the stalk of the ovule. And the point of attachment of this funicle with the body of the ovule, that is called hilum. Here you can see in the body, there is a ridge. And this ridge is known as the raphe. Then it is inside this ovule, you can see a mass of homogeneous tissue. That mass is known as nucellus, diploid tissue. It is protected by two coverings, integuments, and these integuments are outer integument and inner integuments. It produces an opening, a very narrow opening at one end, and that opening is known as micropyle. Now, inside this nucellus, you can see an embryo sac. This structure, this is known as embryo sac. Embryo sac is known as female gametophyte. Very important question. Ovule is known as megasporangium. And homogeneous tissue present inside the ovule is known as nucellus. Then the embryo sac, that is known as female gametophyte. Now here you can see one more aspect. So for a particular ovule, one side there is micropyle, and on the other side, or the end or the pole that is opposite to the micropyle, that is known as chalasa. chalazal end or basal part of the ovule. Now here a little bit extra information, additional information for you people, that is types of ovule. So there are different types of ovule based on the position of microphyll as well as the chalaza. So here the first one, that is orthotropous ovule. You can see here orthotropous ovule. So here it is an erect ovule, straight, erect one. So this erect type of ovule, that is called orthotropous ovule. Here you can see an inverted ovule. That inverted ovule is known as anatropous ovule. It is mentioned in your textbook also, anatropous ovule. Very important question. Draw a neat labeled diagram of an anatropous ovule. So you have to make this type of ovule. It is an inverted ovule. So you can see here, this micropyle is seen near toward funicle. Now, the third type, that is known as hemitropous ovule. Here, the ovule is twisted. It is a twisted ovule, halfway, half twisted ovule. So, such a half twisted ovule, that is known as hemitropous ovule. Then, the fourth one, that is known as camphylotropous. Camphylotropous ovule. Idhar kya ho gaya? Curvature jada ho gaya. The ovule is curved so much in such a way that its micropyle as well as its chalaza, and these two parts are seen on either side of the funicle. This is the funicle. On one side there is chalaza and on the other side there is micropyle. So such an ovule, that is known as camphylotropous ovule. Now the next one, that is amphitropous. Here you can see the ovule. Again, curvature is more. So it becomes horse shoe shaped structure. So a horse shoe shaped ovule is included in your syllabus. It is an additional information for you people. And we have to learn only the anatropous ovule. Now we are going to another important 3-mark or 5-mark question. Very, very important. Megasporogenesis. Yesterday we have learned about microsporogenesis. Here it is megasporogenesis. Okay, what is meant by megasporogenesis? Yes, genesis means formation. The formation of what? Megaspores. Formation of megaspores from megaspore mother cell. That is by which division? Meiosis or reduction division. So why there occurs meiosis or reduction division in this case? So before megasporogenesis, there needs meiosis. Why because these megaspore mother cells are diploid. So formation of haploid megaspores from diploid megaspore mother cell by meiosis or reduction division, that is known as megasporogenesis. Now, how it happens? Megaspore mother cell benega kaase. So this megaspore mother cell, it is formed from one of the nucellar cell. Nucellus ka micropyla region ka ek single cell. So that will enlarges and it forms a specialized cell which is known as megaspore mother cell. We can call it as in abbreviation MMC. MMC. Megaspore mother cell. So this cell, it enlarges. It stores large amount of nutrients and it contains a dense granular cytoplasm and it possesses a prominent diploid nucleus and it enlarges. And this particular cell, that is known as megaspore mother cell, formed from nucellar cell at the micropylar region. Then, since it is a diploid cell, it undergoes meiosis or reduction division and it forms four haploid cells. And these four haploid cells, they are known as the megaspores. And these megaspores, they are arranged in a linear manner. They are arranged in a linear fashion. Since they are four in numbers, they are known as tetrad. So they are forming a group of four cells. And these four megaspores, they are arranged in a single line. So known as linear tetrad. Now, out of these four megaspores, uppermost three megaspores will degenerate. And only the lowermost one that becomes functional. Uppermost three means kaun si wala degenerate yoga? Those three megaspores that are lying on the micropylar region. Micropyl ke paas wala teen megaspores. They will degenerate. And the lowermost one, that means chalasal end wala, ek single megaspore, that becomes functional. Out of the four, three degenerates. Kaun si side ka hai? Micropylar end ka. Or lowermost one wala, that means kaun si end a gaya? Chalasal end. So chalasal end wala megaspore, that will remain as functional. It is the functional megaspore. You can see here the diagram.